Now we turn to President-elect Trump's transition to the White House and how his team is tackling the handover of executive reins. For that, we're joined by Alex Isenstadt of Politico. So, Alex, you're reporting on this every day. Where do things stand right now?
Well, look, I mean, it's a transition that is very much in flux. And you're starting to see a pattern here of a Donald Trump sort of overseeing a process that very much was sort of like his campaign. There was a little bit of chaos involved. You're sort of starting to see some of that chaos seep into the transition a little bit. And perhaps this is a little, perhaps this provides an indication of what Donald Trump's management and leadership style is going to be like once he gets to the White House.
You know, Chris Christie was demoted last week. Mike Pence replaced him and is overarching the kind of lead on this. But there's also been some internal strife. We hear Mike Rogers stepped down. What was behind that?
Well, look, Mike Rogers, former congressman from Michigan, used to head the Intel Committee in Congress. He was very close to Chris Christie, who last week was pushed aside in a leadership shuffle where they put Vice President-elect Mike Pence in charge. And so this is something that you also saw during the campaign where Donald Trump went through several different campaign managers. He's now going through a few different transition heads. You're starting to see sort of a pattern emerge here.
In the grand scheme of things, does it matter? I probably couldn't tell you who managed the transition for the last three, four ever presidents.
No, it's a great question. And to some extent, this is inside baseball. It's parlor game stuff. But to some degree, it does indicate perhaps something about Donald Trump's leadership style, how he oversees things, and exactly how he's going to make some decisions. You know, this comes at a time when a lot of Americans are looking for more information on how Donald Trump is going to lead and how he makes key decisions.
And there also seems to be this tension with what he wanted on the campaign was he ran as an outsider. He wanted people from outside Washington. Yet right now, when you actually have lots and lots of jobs to fill, he's calling on some insiders.
Absolutely. You know, look at the names that you're hearing talked about for top jobs, people like Rudy Giuliani, people like Jeff Sessions, the Alabama senator. These people are, to some degree, they're insiders, but they also share a similar trait, which is that they were all loyal to him during the campaign. At a time during a campaign when a lot of Republicans sought to distance themselves from Donald Trump, he's priding loyalty, and he's looking to those who were loyal to him during the campaign who stood behind him.
He's also now getting the intelligence briefings on a daily basis that President Obama gets. How is that influencing some of the decisions that he has in front of him now?
You know, it's unclear, and it's also unclear exactly how this is shaping who's going to be getting some of these top posts. There was some reporting over the last day or so that Trump wanted clearance for his children and for his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, to also be getting these security clearances. The campaign, or the transition committee, rather, pushed back a little bit on that reporting. But look, it's clear that this is a guy who is new to government, who's new to this kind of thing, and he's now, for the first time, getting this information.
Are transition teams the place where you start to reward your friends who've been loyal to you for so long and eventually maybe in government positions as well?
Well, look, I mean, you look back at George W. Bush's administration. He selected people who were very close to his family, to his father. And so you do see some of that. But it's interesting when you look at the people who Donald Trump is looking at, even people who he's already selected, Reince Priebus, Stephen Bannon, those are people who really played key roles in his campaign and now are going to be overseeing his White House.
All right, Alex Isenstadt of Politico, thanks so much.
Thank you.